I'm Taylor. I just wanted to start by saying just how much of an honor it is to literally be standing up here in front of you all. Time spent on my feet never lasts long enough, but I can't express just how much each moment means to me. Your generosity made this possible and is changing lives, including my own, in ways that you can't even imagine. Saying thank you just doesn't come close enough to expressing the depth of my gratitude. Before I was injured 2 years ago, I remember hearing about tragedies striking in people's lives and naively thinking to myself, that'll never happen to me. Until one day it did. One regular day, just like the countless ones before it. My life changed in ways that I could have never imagined, all from one moment of distraction and impulse by another driver. They watched my car and my life turn upside down on a road that I had driven down a million times before. We can all imagine what we do and how we act when life throws us a setback or two, but if there's one thing I've learned, it's that nothing really ever prepares you for the reality of all the change that takes place after the initial shock. For me, I was humbled and I was given a much needed mortality check. As cliche as I'm sure it's going to sound, I now see the world in a much different way. I notice and appreciate things that I once unknowingly took for granted. Standing hugs, conversations at eye level, the pain of taking the stairs after leg day, or appreciating just how tall I really am. This list really just scratched the surface, and even though I can't have all those things back in my life at this very moment, working with the amazing staff at Shelter Norms and using the Indigo has given me so much gratification in the meantime. Using the Indigo specifically has been such a bittersweet experience for me, and I mean that in the very best way possible. Sweet, because it's given me a taste of my past and a taste of the future that I'm certain awaits me. And bitter, only because I realize all of the things I didn't appreciate enough once upon a time. The beautiful part of that feeling, though, is that both the bitter and sweet sides of this chapter in my life motivate me and have made me into an even more appreciative person. Despite the general prognosis that comes with a spinal cord injury, I have never let my faith and determination waver when it comes to my recovery. The biggest challenge I face each and every day is not knowing whether or not I'll succeed in walking again like I used to. It's having patience with myself and my journey until I reach that point. Even beyond that, though, the key to achieving success is having the right tools to get there, and thanks to all of you, you've provided me part of that. A perfect stranger once told me that whether you think you can or you can't, you're right. Since the day that I heard that, I've not let any time go by where I don't remind myself that I'm capable of doing exactly what I set out to do. Thank you all again so much for turning what I was told would be a can't into a can.